see you. Thank you. Would you state your name for the record, please?
Jennifer Williams.
All right. And are you Othal's mother?
Yes, I am.
All right. Let me get a little background, if I may, from you. How many children do you have?
6 boys and 4 girls.
So 10 altogether?
Yes, sir.
And that includes Othal?
Yes, ma'am. I mean, sir. Sorry.
All right. And where is Othal in the, I guess, the age pecking?
He's the...
Down, in?
He's the third from the oldest.
Third from what?
From the oldest.
Mm-hmm. And so where was Othal born?
Othal was born in Gainesville, Florida. First and foremost, I would like to apologize to Raymond's family. I do have to send my condolences to you all. I understand, you know, I couldn't imagine the pain, but I do understand. I'm sorry that it happened, and I hope you all heal properly. And my son is not a monster, and he's not a murderer. He didn't just go out to murder anyone, and he's definitely not a monster. So that was just an understatement. Othal is such a good father. He has 5 kids, and he takes very good care of them. Othal has not a prejudiced bone in his body, and he healed our family, brought our family back together when they were all separated.
Let me stop you there, because I want to get a little bit more detailed mm-hmm. information about his childhood. So after Othal was born, did he continue to live with you?
Yes, me and my mother.
Okay. For the record, who's your mother?
Brenda Ann Williams.
Is she still with us?
She's deceased.
Okay. And about roughly when did she pass away?
August 31st, 2004.
And for the record, who is Othal's father?
Othal Wallace.
Is that Othal Wallace Sr.?
Yes.
And was his father active in Othal's life or the children's life?
Well, yes, he was. We were off and on because he had so many different women. So he would come through and, you know, make sure Othal had things that he needed and provided those things for him.
Was his father in prison for some reason?
Yes, he did have to go to prison. So he went to prison for selling drugs.
Okay. And so for how long was his father out of the picture for that?
About 7 years.
And over the years, after his father got out of prison, did his father have a relationship?
Yes, they resumed their relationship. Although I got in a motorcycle accident and almost lost his life. He was in intensive care for 1 month, and he was in recovery for a month, during rehabilitation for a month. So he was in Central Florida, and his dad came up there. I stayed up there for the whole term, and his father came up there and bought all the things that he needed, like to bring his legs back together, duals and socks and, you know.
And did there come a time when DCF became involved?
Yes.
Yourself and your children?
Yes, when my sister had been, my mom had passed, and I went off the rocket, you know, I went to the hospital, and my sister cared for my kids, Bristol Williams, and it was domestic violence in the home, and they removed the kids from the home.
Domestic violence in Brenda's home?
And Priscilla Williams' home.
Mm-hmm. Now, were you having some drug addiction issues?
Yes, I was. My results turned into drugs after my mom died, and I was in a dark world.
And did that addiction result in arrests over the years for drug
addiction? Yes, it did. Yes, it did.
Okay. And was that also... So let me back up. How old was Othal when he was taken out of the home?
About 10.
And did Othal go into, where did Othal go at that time?
He went to New Smyrna. He was in, he went for a little while and he went to New Smyrna.
Did there come a time when your parental rights were terminated?
Yes.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Was that about the same time?
Mm-hmm.
And that would be
No, just to Othal, Megan, Dion, and Simeon, okay. And Jessica.
All right. And so, where did Othal go to live after they were removed from him?
He went to a children's home for adolescents.
Okay. And did he stay there?
Yes, because he refused to be adopted. He didn't want to be adopted, so he wanted to find me. He said that he was going to find his mother. And he had told the other kids that he would find the mother, find me, and that we would all be back together. And that he did as such.
Okay. And so what kind of gap are we talking about? He goes in the foster care, and then he...
We're talking about when he was like 17.
Okay. Mm-hmm. All right. And where were you living when you got back together with him?
I was living in Broward County.
And did you continue after Othal was placed in foster care? Did you continue to struggle with your own?
Yes, I did. I was having mental health issues and drug addiction.
Okay. And can you tell the court what kind of mental health issues?
I have bipolar disorder.
Did you have that before the addiction?
Since the age of 13.
Since the age of 13.
Yes.
And, and have you yourself recovered or in recovery from?
Yes, I have been clean 18 months.
Okay. Are you in a particular program for that?
Yes, I am the overseer of a sober living house.
Okay, and where is that?
In Broward County.
So now that you've, for lack of a better word, reunited with Othal, describe the nature of your relationship with Othal.
When Othal came back in my life, he started finding all the kids, getting all the kids together, and he reunited us all together, and we started communicating, and Othal would come check on me often, him and his friend Stephen, and he would make sure that I was okay. When I was in my addiction, he would always come and make sure that I ate. He would come to my house and make sure that everything was going smoothly in my house. Othal was just an overall good kid. He was very respectful. I mean, he doesn't have a hate bone in his body. You know, his life was saved.
Would you like to say to the judge as far as sentencing, which is what we're here for?
Yeah, I know the court is here, but I'm asking you, please, to have the legacy on him so they can reunite with his family. I mean, Othal's not a bad person at all. I don't know how this took place, but I'm very apologetic for it.